There's no question that the Jewish state of Israel is in a more precarious position now than at any time in the last few decades. And that's saying something. Israel is under attack from nearly every quarter. And the reason why is because 11 minutes after Israel declared her sovereignty, May 14th of 1948, the American President Harry Truman announced publicly that the United States recognized the independent sovereignty of the Jewish state. Ever since that date, the United States has had Israel's back. It hasn't always been a perfect relationship, but for the most part, the world has known that if anyone touched Israel, the United States would be there. That all changed on July 20th of 2000. And even more so as we saw this recent UN week in September. And so what we have to do now with this UN agreement going through, releasing sanctions on the leading state sponsor of terror in the world, led by the Ayatollah. And the Ayatollah has stated unequivocally recently that Israel will not exist within 25 years. Soleimani, the head of the Quds Force, has said it will be a privilege to carry out the Ayatollah's wishes. So what we know is that the Ayatollah and Iran cannot achieve their goals and objectives. We need to have someone who will tear up the Iranian agreement and make sure that not only sanctions go on, but more important than that, I don't care who the president is, they need to take our kinetic military means and destroy the instruments of death that are in Iran. We know where these sites are. This has happened three times before in history where rogue sites have been destroyed and therefore they weren't useful to create nuclear bombs, and that's what we have to do. We have to destroy those nuclear sites. That doesn't mean you drop a bomb on a shopping center or kill innocent little kids. We are very precise in what we can do. Together with our allies and with Israel, we could end this menace in Iran, but we need to do it soon. And that's why we need to get someone in office who understands the threat that the world faces. And it's Muslims, it's Jews, it's Christians, it's non-religious people. Everyone is at risk by nuclear Iran, and that has to be stopped by the next president of the United States.